The Iranian Air Force seemed doomed after the U.S. severed ties with Tehran in the 1980s and left the country with an air fleet of aging F-5s and F-14 Tomcats. Nevertheless, to the world's bewilderment, in 2013, Iran abruptly announced the introduction of the country's first indigenous aircraft, and it was no ordinary fighter. It was the Qaher 313, or the Conqueror, a fifth-generation stealth fighter. The Qaher's shape was reminiscent of the Lockheed F-117 Nighthawk, featuring an aerodynamic design to enhance its maneuverability and body panels covered in advanced coatings to provide a low radar signature. The aircraft also featured two internal compartments and the capacity to carry ordnance of over 2,000 pounds. Although little information was ever released about the Qaher, for years, Iran reassured time and time again that the Conqueror would fly in the upcoming years. Still, Western analysts have expressed concerns regarding Tehran's technological capacity to fully develop a functional fifth-generation stealth fighter. Air Force Enigma. In recent memory, people across the globe know that the relationship between the governments of Iran, the United States, and other powers of the West is antagonistic in nature. But this has not always been the case. In the aftermath of World War I and the dissolution of the Ottoman Empire, the Imperial State of Iran had a close relationship with the British Empire, France, and the United States. Although there were some tense moments during World War II, the relationships with the West paid off during the Cold War. During this time, the U.S. and the Soviet Union sought to gain influence in as many countries as possible, and Iran was no exception. The U.S. had already helped Iran develop its nuclear plan since the early 1950s, and decided to provide military support to strengthen the relationships in the region. The final Shah of Iran, Mohammad Reza Pahlavi, welcomed the support to upgrade the country's air force, navy, and army. USAF technicians and pilots began training Iranian personnel to properly use the Northrop F-5 Freedom Fighter, the first American aircraft to be employed by Iran. The reliable F-5 was excellent for taking the fight to Soviet MiGs, but Iran would later receive even more powerful aircraft. These were the McDonnell Douglas F-4 Phantom II and the state-of-the-art Grumman F-14 Tomcat, turning Iran into one of the countries with the most powerful air forces in the Middle East. The decision. But Iran's supremacy and prosperity shattered abruptly with the revolution of 1979, which resulted in the U.S. severing political and military ties with Tehran. An increasing animosity between the two nations followed, leading to undeclared combat during the fight between Iraq and Iran in the 1980s. When Iran ran out of spare parts for its aging American aircraft, it resorted to espionage and the black market to keep its fighters functional. But there was a limit, and when it came, the government embarked on an ambitious idea: develop its own fighter. While Tehran could have turned to Russia and China for support to consolidate its air force with foreign fighters, during the 2010s, Iran inexplicably decided to go for its own design for a stealth fighter. To achieve this, Iran Aircraft Manufacturing Industries Corporation partnered with Iran Aircraft Industries to introduce the F-313 Qaher, or Conqueror, a locally developed fighter for the country's air force. Rollout. In early February 2013, the F-313 stormed onto the global stage when a static mock-up of Iran's design was unveiled amidst a sea of flashing cameras from state media and the watchful eyes of prominent military leaders. Amidst a solemn ceremony that also coincided with the anniversary of the revolution, Tehran's regime boldly asserted that the aircraft was not merely airworthy, but in fact, one of the most advanced fighter jets on the planet. The statement audaciously placed the Conqueror on a pedestal, above even the lauded F-22 Raptor and the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. The Defense Minister's press release to state media detailed a myriad of the fighter's unique attributes, among them a remarkably low radar cross-section, a strategic advantage that would allow the Qaher to operate stealthily at low altitudes, evading enemy radar systems with ease. In a poignant moment, the then-Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad commended the Qaher 313 as a testament to Iran's burgeoning self-reliance in military technology, stating, quote, "Now the speed of Iran's development in science and technology does not depend on circumstances. It depends on our will." Blueprint of a Conqueror. Alongside the rollout, the Iranian MEHR news agency published an article detailing the Qaher's unique features to ease the critics. The Qaher employed two inlets and ducts for its air induction system. The indirect angle of the engine to the inlets reduced radar reflectivity. Additionally, the hot exhaust gas mixed with cold air through the inlet ducts, cooling it before it left the exhaust system, resulting in fewer heat effects on the Qaher's surface. To further affirm its stealth nature, the agency stated the aircraft employed radar-absorbent materials to reduce radar reflection and absorb wave energy. Regarding armament, the Conqueror carried a payload capacity of over 2,000 pounds, split between two compartments. From bombs to smart-guided missiles and air-to-air missiles, Iran claimed the fighter would wreak havoc anywhere it went. The Conqueror's mock-up showed it featured a canopy with all-around visibility, optimizing it for low-altitude flights, ground attacks, and air operations. The cockpit featured 8 analog displays, including multifunction display technology. Aerodynamically, the Qaher's large vertical tail surfaces and angled wings favored stability and maneuverability during flight. Coupled with its overall weight of 14 tons, the Qaher balanced speed, maneuverability, and firepower well. Under fire. Following the 2013 unveiling and the detailed claims about the aircraft, the design quickly overtook social media, online forums, and aviation magazines. Many criticized the design, stating it belonged in a video game. Others established that Iran could come up with an Iranian fighter by cannibalizing parts from other aircraft. While the unveiling sparked intrigue and flaunted Iranian ambition, it immediately induced a wave of international skepticism and criticism. Upon examining the photos and videos of the aircraft, military and aviation experts alike reached a unanimous verdict. There was no way this aircraft would be functional. The cockpit comprised an array of off-the-shelf civilian aviation products, while the instrument panel bore more resemblance to a modern small Cessna turboprop than to a fifth-generation fighter. The aircraft's diminutive dimensions themselves seemed to debunk all claims made by Iranian authorities. It is so compact that it would struggle to accommodate a pilot in the ejection seat, let alone the necessary avionics, fuel, engine, components, and weapons bays. Although the technical specifications announced at the Qaher 313's rollout suggested the fighter could carry 2,000-pound bombs and at least 6 air-to-air missiles without a weapon bay, this feat was deemed impossible. According to one aviation authority, the engine's exhaust duct lacks a nozzle, meaning any use of an afterburner would likely set the entire airframe ablaze instantaneously. One sharp-eyed observer even noted that the Conqueror's wings bear a striking resemblance to those of the vintage MiG-17 model. A stealthy mirage. Some Western military commentators have been so bold as to suggest that the announcement of a stealth aircraft was merely a ruse to mask the shortcomings of their outdated fighter fleet. For years, Iran has endured sanctions, prohibiting the purchase of the essential components needed to construct advanced stealth aircraft. Consequently, it seems highly unlikely that Iran possesses the engineering processes and expertise required to manufacture a stealth aircraft. Despite being universally denounced as a hoax, a mere propaganda exercise intended to dazzle the domestic audience, Iran persistently maintained that their fighter jet was real and already airborne. A later image from 2013 purportedly showed the Qaher being maneuvered in preparation for taxi tests, but this was quickly debunked as a Photoshop attempt. In a bid to instill confidence in 2017, Iran released footage of the Qaher F-313 taxiing around a runway, along with a video supposedly depicting the fighter jet in flight. Nevertheless, experts remained unconvinced, with some suggesting that the alleged test flight was merely a drone. For years, the project seemingly vanished, with no further discussion regarding its viability or future operational plans. From fighter to drone. Despite criticisms and skepticism, the saga of the Qaher 313 took a surprising twist. In February 2023, exactly a decade after the unveiling of the alleged fifth-generation stealth fighter jet, Iran delivered an announcement that seemed to echo comments made years earlier. The Iranian Defense Ministry announced that the Qaher fighter project had achieved complete technological maturity. However, instead of a manned fighter jet, the nation has decided to diversify the project's focus and prepare it for conversion into an unmanned aerial vehicle, or UAV. This proclamation followed the extensive deployment of Iran's Shahed-class kamikaze drones in Ukraine by Russia. Since 2022, these drones have successfully targeted Kyiv's energy and military infrastructure, illustrating the strategic potency of unmanned warfare. In light of these developments, Iran has been intensifying their efforts in the UAV industry in recent years. An Iranian official confirmed that within the year, in addition to the unmanned version, the country would unveil several iterations of the Qaher. The future of this project, more than a decade in the making, promises to be intriguing. The drone version is expected to be unveiled within the next year. While the nation has made substantial strides in missile technology, the dream of developing a fifth-generation fighter jet, capable of challenging the air superiority of its rivals, for now remains just that for Iran. A dream. Thank you for watching Dark Skies. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. For more stories like this, make sure to check out all the other Dark Documentaries channels, where we publish content regularly. Stay tuned for more.